Hi! Due to the way YouTube works, I want to make a quick announcement before this video. If you like this video, please consider hitting the like button or leaving a small comment. It really helps. If you feel like helping even more, you can check my Patreon or Ko-fi accounts. All the links are in the description box. Thank you! Greetings! In today's video, we'll be taking a look at a portable set of Gansai paints. This is particularly exciting because Gansai paints are usually not portable. They tend to come in big pans, in large cardboard boxes, with no mixing area. This set here features 18 colors in half-sized Gansai pans in a nice plastic box. The packaging is simple but really nice. It's a sturdy box containing the palette and a few information papers. This is a paint set directly from Japan, so nothing is translated to English, but there are enough pictures to understand the gist of it. This set is pretty neat in that you can easily shuffle colors around and place in larger pans from other Gansai sets. There's even an extra tray, currently filled with sponges, that you can use to add colors to the set. Inside the box, there's another informative paper and a sticker sheet to label your pans. If you haven't switched pans around yet, they are set in the order that one can see on the other paper, the one with red ink. It's fairly easy to pop out the pans and stick the appropriate label on them. The pans are not clipped or held into place strongly, but they are still quite snug in their trays, so one might need a palette knife or a Swiss knife to help remove the first one in a row. Also, it's probably not advisable to drop or flip this palette, as all the pans would indeed fall out. If that's something that worries you, it can be easily remedied with poster tack under each pan. I made a swatch sheet like I usually do, with color names and also a smaller chart to include with the palette. The names of the colors are in Japanese, but I was able to ask Oto if she could help me with the meaning or translation of the colors' names. It's a bit hard to explain, but a lot of these colors have really poetic names that describe exactly the nuance of the color. Some names refer to a very specific flower, or the powder from a very specific natural source, and so on. To name a few examples, this set has colors like red plum, blue grass, and young leaf. The paints re-wet really well, and they were easy to use, delivering a really bright color payoff. Gansai paints are not like other watercolors. They have different properties and one is not expected to handle them exactly like they would a set of Western watercolors. It's also why the color selection is not similar to the ones we are used to seeing in sets from brands like Winsor & Newton or Schmincke. To test out the paints, I sketched a little scene in my sketchbook. Since this set has a lot of greens and blues, I drew something that happens in the forest. From my experience, the less you end up mixing Gansai paints, the better they look. If you have to mix colors, it's often a better idea to mix colors adjacent on the color wheel or from the same hue. I mixed a few of the greens together to create the colors I wanted, and it worked out pretty well. It's worth noting that these are not artist quality paints. They were designed as hobby paints. There's a difference between the traditional Japanese painting materials and these paints, a bit like you'd have between student or hobby paints and professional paints over here. In that sense, I think it makes this set of Gansai paints more suited to sketchbook or study works rather than finished pieces. As I was painting my sketch, I noticed two things. The first is that these paints are not ideal for layering. You really have to wait for the first color to be completely dry before carefully adding a color on top. And then be careful not to work the color too hard, or you'll reactivate the one underneath and it will make a mess. The second thing I noticed happened with my mix of blue and brown to create a neutral color. I saw that the mix tends to separate super fast, both in the palette and on paper. This is not necessarily a bad thing, as it can bring about really nice textures, but it's a factor to keep in mind if you want to use this mix of colors. The last thing I want to mention was brought to my attention by Otto. As it turns out, these Gansai paints rub off a little bit when dry. I had never noticed this before, but after talking about paints with Otto, she mentioned this and I had to check it out. Overall, I love this set a lot. I love the flat profile of the palette, the sturdy plastic, and the mixing area. I love that I can move the pans around and even put in pans from my other Gansai sets. I have the Kuretake Gansai Tambi set and the pans fit in nicely. The Inky Colors Gansai set pans would also fit in here. It's a really nice palette to have if you want to travel with your Gansai paints. However, it's not exactly a cheap palette. Selling for about 50 Canadian dollars on eBay at the time of posting this video. I haven't seen it sold anywhere else, well, outside of Japan. What do you think of this palette? Let me know in the comments below. Take care, bye bye. Before I leave, here's a reminder that I have accounts on Redbubble and Society6 for fun things like stickers and mugs. Bye bye.